I'm Lori Eggert, and I'm an associate professor at the University of Missouri in the Division of Biological Sciences. I'm originally from Dallas, Texas. I grew up in Texas, but I moved to California about the time that I got married, and so I did all of my schooling in the University of California system.
And what did you study?
I studied ecology in all three of those instances, but during the time that I was a master's student, I decided to focus on genetics. So I picked up a certificate in, you would call that molecular ecology.
Have you always wanted to pursue research, or when did you know that's what you wanted to do?
I originally wanted to be a veterinarian. So I went back being a pre-vet student and took all the same classes that you would need to take to go into research, but decided to become a researcher in my senior year when I took some classes and heard some talks by people who were practicing in conservation genetics. So that was the impetus for my going to becoming a volunteer at the San Diego Zoo Research Lab. And my research career was born at that point. My lab focuses on the topic of ecological and conservation genetics. So we use molecular techniques to be able to answer questions about how organisms interact with both themselves, each other, and the environment. It's also really interesting to study disease in other organisms because some of those can be a really good model for human disease.
Yeah, that's definitely true. What different animals have you studied personally?
Oh, so many. My own research was done on African elephants. My advisor and I decided that there was really nobody studying forest elephants. And forest elephants are highly endangered and needed someone to really focus on understanding their populations. We went from there as a postdoc to working on horses. I've worked on the assateague horses and various other horse populations. I've worked on raccoons, and my students have worked on bears and a lot of other species.
What would you say was your favorite animal to study?
Oh, by far the African forest elephant. They're fascinating.
So cool. And you went to Africa, I'm sure.
Yes, yes. I actually worked in West Africa. I worked in Ghana for my PhD work, and I went on to work in the Ivory Coast or Cote d'Ivoire. I've worked in Gabon and worked in Cameroon, and my students have worked in Gabon again and worked in Kenya. I can't wait to get back to Africa. I love being here at MU. I love being in my office and working with my students, but I also love my field work. My field teams and I always came across things that were surprising. Walking through the forest, there are things that you discover that you don't expect, and one of them had to do with a poacher's camp. We were walking along in the forest in our team, and I had people there with big guns and things because there are actually leopards in the forest. There are multiple things that could be dangerous. There's big snakes, things like that. And we came across a poacher's camp. When we came across that, and took samples there to understand, the meat wasn't recognizable, but we could actually do DNA work to understand what was being poached and to help with the conservation of animals other than elephants. That was one of those times in which I really felt like what I was doing was a lot more worthwhile than what I thought.
Dr. Eggert's lab is not focusing on forest elephants at the moment, but her students continue to use non-invasive methods to study other species.
Well, there are several projects. Probably the premier project at the moment is on the American black bear. And they found that these populations did survive through, that was a time when they had been hunted to extinction, we thought. They did survive, and those populations have since grown and mixed with the reintroduced bears down in Arkansas. And we now have a thriving population in Missouri. What drew me to using non-invasive methods is kind of the same idea that a doctor has, that you first do no harm to your patient. Well, using genetic techniques in populations used to mean that you had to actually capture animals to collect a sample from them. And in some endangered populations, you could actually be harming the animals. The other thing is, if you want to study behavior, you don't want to actually affect the behavior yourself by interacting with the animal. And by using non-invasive methods, we're not affecting them, and we can actually look at how the animals are using the environment without being part of the effect any more than other humans are.
Although Dr. Eggert loves her research now, there was a time she considered giving it all up.
The first time I got malaria in Africa, I will tell you, and it's actually the only time in Africa that I had malaria. I was a very sick girl, but it didn't last more than a day. Because we recognized what it was, we got the cure for it, and I responded immediately to it. But let me tell you, that's a scary thing to look at your own mortality there. That's probably the only time I've ever really thought about giving up on research. There are times when you get a bad review back on a paper or a bad grant proposal review that you think, for a half a minute, you think, oh, I'm just going to chuck it all and go do something else. But that's not the way it is. We all have to face those, and it's just part of being a researcher.
And what would you say is your favorite part of your job?
My favorite part of my job is probably working with my students. I enjoy my grad students. I really do, and I enjoy talking with them. And I enjoy, even when things get tough, when they get a bad review, or when they email me from the field and things aren't going well, I really enjoy working with them. That's why I stay in this, not because my ego is not so big that this is all about me. This is also all about the working on the projects and working with students.
Dr. Eggert urges students interested in research to follow their passion.
Go out there and actively pursue it. It's the thing that really got me started was walking up to someone who came in and talked to our class, getting the guts to walk up to him and say, can I come volunteer in your lab? That's a scary thing to do, but it was totally worthwhile, and you will find that a lot of us are very, very open to those kinds of things. So if you're devoted to research and you really want to do it, go out there and start doing it.